Are you confused in the differences between these terms spondylosis, spondylitis, spondylolysis and spondylolisthesis? So let's clear our concepts in this video. So don't forget to watch this video till end and welcome back to my channel Medico's Guide. Now let's discuss each term one by one. So first of all, we have here is the spondylosis. And spondylosis refers to a degenerative condition that affects the spine, particularly the vertebra and the intervertebral discs. It involves the wear and tear of the spinal structures due to the age-related changes, such as the formation of the bone spurs, disc degeneration, and the thickening of the ligaments. Spondylosis is a broad term. It's used to describe the general degenerative changes that occur in the spine and can lead to the symptoms like the pain, stiffness, and decreased mobility. Now this next term is spondylitis, and spondylitis is also known as spinal arthritis. It is an inflammatory condition that primarily affects the spine. It involves the inflammation of spinal joints, vertebra, leading to the pain, stiffness, and sometimes fusion of the affected vertebra. Now, ankylosing spondylitis. It is a specific type of the spondylitis and is characterized by the inflammation of the spine and pelvis, which can result in a stoop posture and limited spinal mobility. Now, our next term is spondylolysis. And spondylosis is a term often used interchangeably with spondylolysis, but they have distinct meanings. The word spondylysis refers to the degenerative changes in the spine as mentioned earlier. However, the spondylolysis refers specifically to the defect or the fracture in the vertebra, typically in the pars interarticularis, which is a small bridge of the bone connecting the facet joints in the back of the spine. And spondylolysis is commonly seen in the lower back and can be a precursor to the spondylolisthesis. Now, let's discuss the last term, and that is the spondylolisthesis. Spondylolisthesis is a condition where the one vertebra slips forward over the vertebra below it. And this displacement can occur due to the various factors including spondylolysis, that is a vertebral defect or fracture, or the degenerative changes in the spine, that is a spondylosis. Spondylolisthesis can result in the spinal instability, nerve compression, and the symptoms like the low back pain, sciatica, and the muscle weakness. The severity of the spondylolisthesis is typically graded on a scale from 1 to 4 based on degree of the slippage. So guys, that's it from my side, and I hope that this video has cleared out the difference between these terms, and I hope you learned something from this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.